Hello, my friends. Today we are going to continue the part two of our personal narrative editing checklist. A lot of times in the classroom, we would do peer editing, which means we would take our paper and we would find a couple people around the room. We'd all get different colored pens and we would edit each other's papers, right? But that's a little bit harder to do in person. So the last week or so, we have done small edits each day in different colors, and that has helped for us as your teachers to be able to see specifically where you were looking at and kind of color coding the process of your editing that you just did for yourself. And maybe in the future we can do peer editing. I'm not kind of totally dismissing that, but this time for this paper, we are going to focus on just editing our own papers, and we'll maybe revisit peer editing another time. So last week we had a checklist of things that we wanted to go over on Friday to kind of do the step one of editing for your personal narrative. And today we're going to go through the step two checklist of your personal narrative. So if you see me looking like in this direction, it's because I have the checklist up and I'm just going to make sure I review all of it in this video. So if I glance over here, I'm not sidetracked. I'm just trying to keep on track. So today, the very first thing you're going to do on the slide after this is you're going to see a new checklist, and it has little check marks by it or by each little key that you're going to check for. When you have gone through your entire paper and you've like, yep, I got this, put a little check. You can use the scribble tool. You can use the check mark icon. If you go to like add an image and then you select shape, you can do a little check mark. Whichever way you prefer. And I know sometimes this seems like a little bit tedious or time consuming, but when you go through your paper and you ask the questions that you need to ask and you are sure that it's your best work, it's going to result in you handing in your best work and getting the best grade that you can. So this process is just as important as any process in the writing stages. So the first thing that we're going to talk about is, did I spell commonly used words correctly? So when you are going through and you're editing your paper, you're going to see that your paper will have, or your Google Doc will have, little squiggles under any line or under any word that is spelled incorrectly. You don't want to ignore that. You actually want to right click on the word and it will show you how to spell it correctly. So there might be words where you're like, I know that I spelled that right. Maybe it's a person's name that's less common than others, so it shows that little squiggle line. Those are things that you can ignore. You know, my name, for example, Liesl is my first name. Anytime I type it into a document, it shows those little squiggles, even though it's, I know how to spell my own name. So I understand that that happens sometimes, but generally, you know, if maybe you put for the word sit and it has a little underline in it because you put two I's or two T's or something like that on accident, just go and make sure that you make sure that all of your commonly used words are spelled correctly. When you are done with that, you're going to mark it off as being something that you have checked off, and you're going to move on to, did I begin each sentence with a capital letter? So every time there is any sort of punctuation indicating the end of a sentence, like a question mark, an exclamation point, or a period, you are going to make sure that the letter that follows it is a capital letter. When you've done that, you'll check it off and you'll move on to, did I end each sentence with a punctuation mark, which is what we just talked about. So sentences need to always end in some form of punctuation, and that's because the reader is going to be looking for that as like almost a moment for their brain to pause and then move on to the next thing. So a challenge is for you to read your story out loud, and unless you find punctuation, don't take a breath. If you realize that you've gotten to a certain point in your story and you're like out of breath, that means that you're missing punctuation, and you'll want to go in there and add that punctuation in where you would take your normal pauses or breaths in the speaking out of your story. So when you have gone through and made sure that all of your punctuation is included, you are going to check it off and move on to, are all of my sentences complete sentences. So last week we talked about stretching our sentences and making sure that they're longer than 3 to 4 words. And I know that we said, you know, maybe it was like we went or we played outside often. Right? And we said you can use the checklist of like who, what, when, and where, right? So you could say, my sister Sam and I played outside in the backyard every morning before school started to get our energy out. So you're talking about where you went, who you went with, why, and what you were doing. That's just one example, but making sure that all of your sentences are longer than 3 to 4 words and are considered complete. When you're done with that, you will mark it off and you will move on to, are there any run-on sentences? And run-on sentences is what I was talking about earlier, where if you read the story out loud and you realize you're out of breath, that is a run-on sentence. That's where you would add that punctuation to make sure that your story flows nicely, both mentally and verbally. After that, you are going to make sure that you capitalize all proper nouns. So proper nouns is something we talked about last week as well. Those are people, places, things, anything like that. If it's a noun and it's specific to like a person's name, a place, anything like that, you are going to want to make sure that you capitalize those words or the first letter of those words rather. When you're done with that, you will put another tick mark showing that you are done, and you will move on to the last part of the checklist for today, which is, did I use quotation marks around dialogue? So sometimes, you know, like even in my writing, sometimes if I am putting dialogue in, I might remember the first quotation mark, like I'll put it around one side, it'll be like, whatever I said, and then I forget this one, right? So making sure that your quotation marks are present at the beginning and end of whatever somebody says. And that you are making that very clear that that was a spoken thing that was said and not just a thought in your head that you are wanting to jot down on paper. So that is all of the revision checklist for today. If you have any questions about any of the details of that checklist, please feel free to reach out to me if I'm your teacher or your teacher if I'm not, and we would be happy to help you. Office hours are always a good time to pop by, or during our morning meeting, or during question and answer time, anything like that. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I look forward to seeing how your writing process is going.